中国和印度17号就拉达克时空线举行了第16轮军长级会谈。参加会谈的印度代表团由列城第14军司令森古普塔中将率领，而中国方面则是由南将军区司令杨林少将率领。我们来看本台新德里记者的报道。
中印两军于17日举行了第16轮军长级会谈，于上午9:30左右在时空线印度一侧的初舒尔摩尔多会合点开始，一直进行到晚上10点，为解决拉达克地区剩余摩擦点的所有未解决问题进行了进一步讨论，重点为德普桑地区的巡逻点和温泉区的问题。本次会谈在时隔4个月后举行，3月的第15轮军长级会谈在拉达克摩擦点进一步脱离接触方面未能取得任何突破。印度媒体报道称，此次会谈是在时空线上空紧张局势加剧之际举行的。两国空军的战机在时空线地区的飞行频率有所增加。两国外长本月27、28日可能在塔什干再次会晤。
Both sides have remained engaged with large number of troops and equipment deployed along the line of actual control. It has been reported that the hot springs area would be an easier issue to resolve.But we are aware that Demchok and Dipsang plains and other such areas remain a matter of contention. I feel that it is unlikely that the 16th round of talks would have resulted in any definitive solution. Through the meeting that was held between Wang Yi, Foreign Minister of China, and Dr. Jaishankar, External Affairs Minister of India, where the Indian minister urged China to restore peace and tranquility by complete disengagement between the two sides.So going forward, we can predict that the two sides will continue to meet, especially at the border level, and exchange differing perceptions and matters of disagreement, essentially to buy some time for the domestic leadership.To focus on issues which will restore stability in both countries.
7月7日，印度外交部长苏杰生与中国国务委员兼外长王毅在巴厘岛20国集团外长会议期间举行的会谈中，谈到了拉达克东部的局势。双方讨论了早日解决拉达克东部所有悬而未决问题的重要性。在班公湖地区发生暴力冲突后，拉达克东部边境对峙于2020年5月5日爆发。此后，双方逐渐加强了士兵和重兵器的部署。经过一系列军事和外交会谈，中印双方去年在班公湖南安和格格拉地区完成了脱离接触进程。不过，目前双方在时空线沿线敏感地区约有5万至6万名士兵。凤凰卫视记者商金军印度新德里采访报道。